Hi, I'm Amber, a math writer with The Good and the Beautiful. Today, I'm going to talk with you about spiral math, why it works, and how our new Simply Good and Beautiful math curriculum uses this approach. First, what is spiral math? There are two types of teaching methods that are commonly used in math curriculums today: mastery and spiral. A mastery approach focuses on teaching one concept until it is mastered before moving to a new skill. A spiral approach presents a new concept, provides some practice, and then moves on to another skill. A skill is reviewed and revisited within each level and from one level to the next, continuously adding on to prior learning. To demonstrate the difference between these two approaches, let's look at this tower of blocks and this spring. This tower is like the mastery approach. The bottom block must be placed before the other blocks can be placed on top. Think of each block as a mastered math concept. Before learning a new math concept, the previous concept must be mastered. One problem with this approach is if the child struggles to learn the first concept, it may take some time before he or she can move on to a new concept, making the building of this tower, or in this case, the child's math knowledge, a longer process. Another problem can occur when the child moves on before the concept is mastered, or if the child begins to forget the concept learned earlier because of a lack of review. In all these scenarios, the child's learning can be compromised because this approach relies on the mastery of concepts that are built upon one another. So if we were to pull out this block here, the rest would fall. If this happens, a child can have a weak understanding of math and continue to struggle as he or she tries to learn upper-level math concepts. Now look at the spring. Imagine that each coil represents many math concepts, starting with the most basic understanding of those concepts. As you travel up the coil, it circles back to the same concept, but this time building upon it, creating a stronger understanding and connecting it to prior learning. Each time the coil circles back, the child builds confidence in applying the math concept. Because of this cycle of revisiting and reviewing math concepts, the understanding the child builds is not easily broken and creates a strong math foundation and ensures that he or she doesn't forget the prior concepts due to the frequent review. Simply Good and Beautiful Math uses the spiral approach. I'll give you a few examples of how it is used while I share three reasons why it works. Number one, spiral math introduces students to new concepts gently and slowly builds the student's confidence and understanding of the concept over time. For example, in early levels of the Simply Good and Beautiful Math, a child is first introduced to addition using manipulatives, then moves to written problems in Math K. Then the child works slowly up from single-digit addition in Math 1 and adding multi-digit numbers and money, shown as decimal numbers, in Math 2. When each new concept is introduced, it builds on the child's prior knowledge. Connecting new learning to prior knowledge helps the child with retention of math concepts. Number two, spiral math continually reviews concepts that have been taught. This enables children to retain knowledge of different math concepts while learning new skills. Here are just a few examples across all math levels. Simply Good and Beautiful Math excels at this by including review sections after each lesson. These review sections revisit concepts learned earlier to ensure the information is not forgotten. They also revisit concepts that will be built upon in upcoming lessons. Not only does Simply Good and Beautiful Math review within the same level, but it also brings review of previous concepts across levels. Concepts taught in a prior level are reviewed at the beginning of the next level and then built upon. For example, Math 3 teaches how to identify quadrilaterals, while Math 4 and 5 reviews and builds upon this concept by introducing how to classify different types of quadrilaterals. Number three, spiral math provides variety. Since children revisit math concepts more frequently throughout the course, new concepts can be taught without interrupting the flow of learning or retention of other skills. This ensures that the student is not stuck on one concept for a long period of time until it is mastered. Why is this important? If a child works on the same concept for multiple lessons in a row and is not able to move on to a new skill until mastery has been achieved, the child may become discouraged or bored with the concept. Including variety in the concepts taught and in what order they are presented allows the student to encounter new math concepts that bring a refreshing break from continuously practicing difficult math skills. For example, Simply Good and Beautiful Math 4 teaches many lessons on multi-digit multiplication and long division. These concepts are taught throughout the entire course, and they are mastered by the end of the course rather than in one unit. This allows for other skills to be weaved between these important math concepts and gives students variety in their learning. To wrap up, spiral math is a great way to teach math to children. Why? First, it teaches concepts and builds upon them over time. Second, children will review concepts many times to ensure the knowledge they have obtained is not forgotten. And third, a variety of math concepts throughout the course allows for a more engaging math experience while still building a solid math understanding. Pair these advantages with the learning style and quality of Simply Good and Beautiful Math, and you've got a winning math curriculum. A curriculum that engages students with real-world math, connections to culture, nature, art, God, and high moral character, and a solid math approach that builds a strong foundation in math that continues to grow throughout the years. What else could you ask for? It truly is Simply Good and Beautiful Math.